Welcome to EPG Patashala. I am Ravi Kori Setter, Senior Fellow, Dr. V.S. Wakankar, Archaeological Research Institute in Bhopal. In the subject of Indian culture and paper 2 on pre- and proto-historic cultures of India, in this presentation, we will be looking at the emergence of Neolithic culture in the Indian subcontinent with background information from the neighboring continental areas such as Africa, Southwest Asia, and Eastern Asia. Information regarding the emergence of Neolithic way of life from these geographical regions is very, very important to be able to understand the manner in which various types of food crops that have been cultivated in India have been introduced into this particular region through cultural processes. The aim of this particular presentation is to emphasize the importance of evidence of earliest food crops cultivated in Southwest Asia, earliest food crops cultivated in Africa, as well as the earliest food crops cultivated in Eastern Asia. The broad spectrum of food crops that have been cultivated from the earliest times include a variety of cereals, pulses, and millets, including oil seeds as well as fiber crops. And vegiculture also played an important role in the rise of variety of plant foods that were included as part of the subsistence economy of agricultural communities. As we all know, Neolithic culture marks the beginning of agricultural way of life, and the antecedents of the Neolithic way of life is also equally important to understand the processes that led to transition from hunting-gathering way of life to early agricultural way of life. Therefore, understanding of the emergence of Neolithic cultures across the old world, particularly in Africa, Southwest Asia, and Eastern Asia, are important for us, because based on the current knowledge of Neolithic cultures in these regions, it has now been possible to identify the fact that the Neolithic culture has an early emergence in Southwest Asia, Eastern Asia, as well as in Africa. In the context of understanding the emergence of earliest settlements in the Indian subcontinent, we also try to obtain adequate background of African prehistory. And in the context of early Paleolithic settlements in the Indian context, we try to look at the emergence of human settlements in the context of two very important models, which are referred to as out of Africa 1 and out of Africa 2. When we look at the Neolithic archaeobotanical record from a variety of sites across the Indian subcontinent, we also get a picture of the fact that some of the crops were first developed in Southwest Asia, Africa, and Eastern Asia, and were later introduced into the Indian subcontinent. It has also become possible to identify independent centers of agricultural origins in the Indian subcontinent, which was characterized by the first exploitation and adoption of local millets, local cereals, local pulses, and such other plant foods. Introduction. The Neolithic phase is best defined as the halfway house between the hunting-gathering simple societies and the emergence of first civilizations of the world. The following quote from the French archaeologist J. Cauvin aptly sums up the importance of the Neolithic way of life that paved way for rapid changes in the life ways of human societies, ushering in great discoveries and inventions and successful exploitation of natural resources and the rise of political economies across the world. I quote, "Among the great turning points in human history, the one called the Neolithic Revolution is one of the most critical. It concerned the beginning of the first manipulation of natural environment by our species, and it lies directly at the origins of our present power. The analysis of this metamorphosis in its circumstances and its causes is therefore an indispensable first stage of those who were interested in civilization began. This event occurred first in the Near East before radiating directly into other regions or giving place to later imitations elsewhere. Therefore, the development of Neolithic cultures in the Indian subcontinent can be best understood against the background of early developments in the three distinct geographical regions of Southwest Asia, Africa, and East Asia. In these three continental regions, we have the earliest evidence of domestication of cereal crops such as wheat and barley, millet crops like jowar and ragi, and rice in the Eastern Asian region. Eastern Asia is considered the primary area of rice cultivation, whereas the foothill regions of Zagros and Taurus Mountains in Southwest Asia, particularly in the Levantine region, there is the earliest evidence of cultivation of wheat and barley. In Central and Northern Africa, different millets and pulses were first cultivated, and all these varieties of crops were gradually introduced into other areas outside Southwest Asia, outside Africa, as well as outside Southeast Asia and Eastern Asia. When and where Neolithic way of life started and spread across? The period between 12,000 and 4,000 years ago witnessed the transition of prehistoric hunter-gatherers into the village-based first farmers and the first herders at different points of time in different geographical regions of the world. It is also very aptly said that this transformation was not limited to only subsistence production and the modification of landscape, but also witnessed changes from the most material to most symbolic. Habitat, technology, demography, social organization, settlement, and the use of space and artistic and religious expressions were equally involved. The radiocarbon chronology of Southwest Asian and East Asian Neolithic sites has rendered in proper delineation of rapid development of socio-economic changes. The radiocarbon chronology has also clearly established the fact that it was in Southwest Asia Neolithization first arose without any external influence, and all other centers of Neolithic cultures are later, and that diffusion and migration played important role in the spread of Neolithization across the world. As can be understood by this statement, certain geographical areas processed native food crops which were identified by early Neolithic communities inhabiting those regions, and from the first domestication of these plants and successful Neolithization gradually led to expansion of the territory of the Neolithic communities, and at the same time expansion of these food crops to newer geographical areas. In the context of available radiocarbon dates, it has been possible to trace when and where for the first time cereals were cultivated, when and where for the first time millets were cultivated, and when and where for the first time rice was cultivated. The term agriculture refers to all activities involving cultivation of plants. Cultivation is defined as a conscious activity and refers to it as an essential component of any agricultural system, defines a sequence of activity whereby crops are planted as seed or vegetative crop, protected, harvested, then deliberately sown again, usually in the prepared plot of ground in the following growing season. Domestication also refers to conscious activity which leads to identifying plant remains that show recognizable indications of morphological change away from the wild phenotype, attributable to human interference in the phenotype through cultivation. On the basis of archaeological and archaeobotanical record of early agricultural societies, several major regions of independent agricultural origins directly from hunter-gatherer background have been identified by Peter Bellwood. They are as follows. 1. Southwest Asia includes the Fertile Crescent in the region east on the eastern Mediterranean coast, including the modern states of Israel, Syria, Lebanon, and Iraq. Earliest evidence of domestication of wheat, barley, pea, lentil, sheep, goat, pig, and cattle occurred in this region. 2. East Asia, including China. Yangtze and Yellow River basins, we have the earliest evidence of domestication of rice, foxtail millet, varieties of tubers, fruits, pig, and poultry. Foxtail millet is one of the smaller millets compared to the larger millets like ragi and jowar. 3. New Guinea. Interior highlands of New Guinea, we have the earliest evidence of cultivation of taro, sugarcane, pandanus, banana, and of course, in this case, there is no evidence of domestication of animals. Number four, Mesoamerica, the region between southern North America and northern part of Southern America, including Mexico and Southern America. Domestication of maize, beans, squashes, manioc, and many fruits and tubers with minor domestication of animals occurred here, independent of influence from any other region. USA, eastern woodlands, squashes, and various seed-bearing plants were first cultivated here, but there is no evidence of animal domestication. Central and West Africa, yams and African rice were first domesticated. Number seven is Southern India, especially in the region where we have the Southern Neolithic, mid-Deccan plains with evidence of cultivation of local millets and tubers. In the Indian subcontinent, a couple of more areas have also been recently identified where small millets were cultivated before the introduction of crops from outside, such as the Western India in Gujarat. Geographically, the Indian subcontinent is placed between the countries of Western Asia and those of East Asia. The crops involved in the Neolithic economies of the Indian subcontinent fall into four groups in terms of ultimate origin: from Southwest Asia, Africa, East Asia, and native South Asia. Therefore, in order to assess the Indian achievements in the global context, it would be worthwhile to have background knowledge of the recent evidences on this subject in these contiguous landmasses. Southwest Asia. Southwest Asia has the largest area of Mediterranean climate, generally hot, dry summers and cold winters, with greatest range of altitudinal variation. This region has the largest number of large-seeded annual wild cereals and pod-bearing legumes species. Legumes include broad beans, peas, chickpeas, and lentils. Wheats, emmer, a hulled variety tetraploid, and einkorn, a hulled diploid, and including barley and rye were the first to be widely cultivated in the Fertile Crescent or Levant, the region which includes Syria, Jordan, Palestine, Israel and Iraq, and later in Turkey, that is Anatolia. Wheat and rye were domesticated in the Levant by about 8500 BC. Barley cultivation also coincided with this time period. While barley has a widespread distribution across Southwest Asia, extending up to Anatolia, North Africa and Afghanistan. The leguminous pea, lentil and chickpea are all of Levantine origin. They were first domesticated after about 8000 BC. In Southwest Asia, the archaeological record reveals that courses towards agriculture begins around 19000 BC. After 15000 BC, the geometric Heberan culture, a microlithic producing community, lived in caves and small campsites. The descendants of the Heberan culture have been identified as Natufians, dated to around 12500 BC. The Natufian culture witnessed increase in the human population, especially before the commencement of the Younger Dryas cold phase around 11000 to 9500 BC. There is evidence of exploitation of wild barley. Some Natufian sites have preserved evidence for exploitation of wild barley, einkorn and lentils, and after the end of the Younger Dryas cold phase, the archaeological record reveals widespread appearance of domesticated plants. The Natufian culture is followed by Khiamian culture. They flourished between 10,000 and 9,500 BC, but precedes the pre-pottery Neolithic period A, or Sultanian, Aswadian, and Murabitian cultures. The first signs of agricultural economy appear in these cultures. The PPNA is followed by pre-pottery Neolithic B, well documented from the site of Jericho in Israel. This phase, having a long time span of 8600 to 7000 BC, witnessed cultural efflorescence as well as geographical unity for the whole of the Levant. This was characterized by a developed stone tool technology, typology, rectangular architecture, animal herding and cultivation. PPNB developed in three stages, the early PPNB between 8600 and 8200 BC, the middle PPNB between 8200 and 7500 BC, and late PPNB between 7500 and 7000 BC. These three stages witnessed gradual efflorescence and spatial expansion of agricultural way of life beyond the Levant into the Middle Euphrates, the Taurus, Palestine, and southern Anatolia. This map reveals the spread of agriculture from the Levantine corridor in the directions towards Europe as well as towards Central Asia. By 8500 BC, the agricultural way of life was full-fledged in this Levantine corridor. Subsequent periods witnessed the expansion of agricultural economies as shown in this particular map. Beyond Southwest Asia, further south, we enter into Northern Africa. This is the largest continent on the earth, and it is generally opined that the Levant forms an extension of Northern Africa, particularly those archaeologists dealing with the expansion of human populations out of Africa. However, in the context of Neolithic developments, the movement of peoples and expansion of agricultural origins from Northern Africa as yet a secondary place. Northern Africa is broadly divisible into Sahara, Sub-Sahara, Africa, the regions lying north of equatorial rainforests. Although early theories of agricultural origins or the Neolithic Revolution was centered on Egypt's Nile Valley, ironically, the evidence of the single center of Neolithic origins has not stood the test of time. Both Sahara and Sub-Sahara regions have received adequate research focus on the Neolithic transitions, which took place between 2000 BC and early historic time. Geophytological documentation in these regions has established the presence of a variety of summer rainfall cereals, including African rice and millets. The most significant crops are African rice, oryza, globirena, pearl millet, sorghum, and finger millet. The sub-Saharan early agriculture was based on this package of crops, while in Northern Africa, it was governed by the introduction of Southwest Asian cereals and legumes. It is to be noted that the region south of the equator has drawn a blank in respect of evidence for early Neolithic transitions. However, some of the Egyptian terminal Pleistocene sites have shown up evidence of exploitation of wild sorghum millet. Many of these crops came to be introduced into the Indian subcontinent during the 3rd and 2nd millennium BC. Variety of wild millet grains and impressions on pottery occur in many sites across the Sahara about 8500 BC and later. Although evidence for actual cultivation is not clear, people were harvesting morphologically wild sorghum and pearl millet. There is suggestion that cultivation occurred in Sudan around 5000 BC. North Africa has evidence for native cattle, and possibly they were domesticated early in the Neolithic. By 6000 BC, sheep and goat were already part of the Neolithic in Egypt and Sudan, which had a Southwest Asian source. In Sudan, the evidence for domesticated cattle, sheep and goat dates to around 5000 BC. People who kept these animals moved southwards into the Sub-Sahara by about 2500 BC. They practiced animal herding along with hunting-gathering, made pottery, and as yet there is no evidence of cultivation around this time. This map clearly gives a picture of variety of cereals and particularly millets such as sorghum and Eleusine Caracana, and some of the pulses like lentils like Lablab purpureus and Panicetum glaucum, that is Bajra, as native to Africa. This map also gives us a picture of the domestication involving sheep and goat. The earliest domestication of sheep and goat goes back to 6000 BC, and later it occurs in the neighboring geographical areas in Northern Africa. This map identifies the potential independent centers of domestication of both plants as well as animals. The Levantine corridor, we have a series of sites including Abu Huraya, Mirabit, Jeff El Amara, and such other sites. Further northwards, towards the foothills of Taurus and Zagros Mountains, we have a set of sites. Further southeast of Levantine, along the eastern Mediterranean coast, we have a series of sites, Ain Ghazal, Khayyam, and such other sites which have yielded early evidence of pre-pottery Neolithic A and pre-pottery Neolithic B, which were the cultivation centers in the 9th millennium BC. These two maps of the old world, including Africa, Europe and Asia, give us a clear picture of the fact that the Indian subcontinent is placed in between two broad geographical areas such as East Asia and Southwest Asia and Africa. These are the regions where we have absolute dates for the earliest domesticated food crops dating back to 11,000 BP in the Fertile Crescent area and dating back to 5th millennium BC in sub-Saharan Africa and 9,000 BC in Yangtze and Yellow River valleys in China. So the crops that came to be cultivated in these regions were gradually introduced into the Indian subcontinent during the course of development of Neolithic way of life across the Indian subcontinent. And this also gives us a clear picture that agricultural origins did not take place simultaneously in all these areas. The fact that there is time difference between these sets of geographical areas, it is possible to infer dispersal of crops from one epicenter to another region where they were introduced and successfully adopted. In East Asia, recent years have witnessed significant progress in prehistoric researches. In China, particularly in the Yellow River Valley and in the middle and lower reaches of the Yangtze River, here the earliest Neolithic cultures are represented by the Pelei, Gang, Shishan and Dadiwan cultures. They are followed by the Yangshaho culture and its successor. The Lungshan culture, both based on the Hoi culture and distributed mainly in northern China. All these cultures dated between 6000 and 5000 BC were based on agricultural economy which comprised cultivation of foxtail millet, broomcorn millet and rice. Agriculture was supplemented by animal husbandry. Bones of pigs, dogs and poultry as well as a few ox bones have been recovered from the earliest Neolithic cultures in China and later in the Lungshan culture, sheep, goats and horse appear. Early Neolithic sites are dated to around 7000 BC, during which time large agricultural villages came into existence. Unlike in Southwest Asia, the first appearance of pottery predates the Neolithic and the oldest pottery is dated to be as old as 9000 to 12000. Unlike in Southwest Asia, the first appearance of pottery predates the Neolithic and the oldest pottery is dated to be as old as 9000 to 1200 BC. These researches show that China is one of the centers of origin of agriculture in the world and the development of prehistoric agriculture in East Asia at least is indissolubly linked to the contributions of China. In recent years, several hundred Neolithic cultural sites have been excavated over most of China. Numerous Neolithic sites in North China such as Dadiwan in eastern Gansu province, Pilingan in western Henan province, and Shishan in southern Hebei province have on record that the appearance of dry farming dates back to 5000 to 6000 BC. While several Neolithic sites along the Hangzhou estuary such as He Mo Du on the southern bank and Louji Jiao in the southeastern Yangtze Delta have recorded that the origin of domesticated paddy rice in South China is as early as 5000 BC. At the moment, it seems that annual millets such as foxtail millet, Setaria italica, were cultivated in the Yellow River Basin by perhaps 6000 BC and the annual rice is in the lower Yangtze Valley by at least 5000 BC. The eastern region of China, drained by the Yellow and Yangtze rivers and the smaller rivers between them, provided the fertile stretches of arable land and wild progenitors of the early domesticates of the Chinese Neolithic. Evidently, this region witnessed the early development of agricultural origins. This is a monsoon rainfall area covered by fertile tracts of loessic soil. There is no evidence of primary agricultural development in any other regions of China outside the regions of middle reaches of the Yellow and Yangtze rivers and the Huy Basin. Early developments of agriculture in this region is comparable to those in Southwest Asia. Large number of early Neolithic sites found distributed in the middle Yellow River Basin, the region of early millet cultivation. Neolithic sites in the middle Yangtze Basin are found located on the lake shores associated with floodplains. Against this background, when we look at the archaeobotanical record from regional archaeological sites dating from the early Holocene in the Indian subcontinent, it has now been possible, based on the availability of radiocarbon dates, to arrive at regional variation in the way in which agricultural transition from hunting-gathering to sedentary agricultural economies occurred in the Indian subcontinent. As we can see in the columns shown here, the first column refers to the region of Balochistan, particularly the Bolan Valley sites, where the site of Mehrgarh has been excavated. At Mehrgarh, we have clear evidence of the early development of agricultural way of life going back to nearly 7000 BC. That is the time period when we first see the introduction of Near Eastern crops, followed by the expansion of agricultural settlement beyond the Bolan Valley towards the greater Indus Valley. Between 7000 BC to about 2500 BC was the time period when the gradual expansion of Neolithic economies gave rise to the early urbanization processes that led to the emergence of Indus Valley civilization in the greater Indus Valley. Further eastwards and north of the greater Indus Valley is the Kashmir Valley, where the sites like Semthan, Gufral and Burjahom have been excavated. And in this context also, we have direct evidence of expansion of Near Eastern crops into the Kashmir Valley. Prior to the introduction of Near Eastern crops, this region was inhabited by hunter-gatherer communities. South of the Greater Indus Valley, we enter into the Saurashtra region, where until about 2500 BC, we have no evidence of the beginning of Neolithic economies in this region. In recent years, research on identification of an independent center of agricultural origins in Gujarat has been successful, where archaeobotanists have been able to identify the occurrence of native millet crops and which were adopted by the hunter-gatherers and cultivated subsequently. And this particular process has occurred in Gujarat by around 3000 BC. Later, this region also witnessed introduction of crops of Southwest Asian origin via the Indus Valley. Further eastwards, further northeast of Gujarat, we enter into Aravalli region of Rajasthan. Here, the Mesolithic hunting-gathering economies survived as recently as 2500 BC. Subsequently, there is a documentation of the presence of agro-pastoral communities and the evidence for a regular agriculture based on crops introduced from Southwest Asia has been documented in Ahar and Banas cultures. In the Middle Ganga Valley, we have clear evidence of very early domestication of rice, and this region has gained significance in our understanding of the early cereal cultivation based on rice agriculture dating back to at least 6000 BC. And its relationship with East Asian rice cultivation settlements is not as yet clear, but at least the radiocarbon dates suggest that the Ganga Valley, including North Central India, formed part of the primary area of rice cultivation in early Holocene times. As we move further southwards on the Deccan Plateau, we have Northern Deccan and Southern Deccan sites. While in the Northern Deccan, we do not have clear evidence for a Neolithic substratum, whereas majority of agricultural settlements are in advanced stage with knowledge of copper technology. Here we have a package of food grains including crops introduced from Southwest Asia via the Indus Valley, as well as the millets of African origin introduced in the Malwa and Jorve cultures. Southern Deccan is an important region where we have the clear evidence of domestication of local millets, and agricultural history of this region is very well described in the following model on Southern Neolithic cultures. Further south of the Deccan is the Tamil Nadu plains, where we have a package of grains which were which included millets as well as the crops introduced from the east during the Megalithic time period by around 1000 BCE. This particular geographical variation within the Indian subcontinent has helped us in establishing the fact that the native crops were first adopted by the early agro-pastoral communities, and with the development of agro-pastoral economy, the crops from and expansion of settlement networks, crops from different areas were introduced. For more details, you are advised to go through the e-text. Thank you.